Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Facebook Live event here at Parkview Health. We're coming at you every Friday in the month of March. It's National Nutrition Month, and we're teaming up with Parkview's amazing and esteemed registered dietitians. We're joined today by Olivia, and she's going to be talking about breakfast. We have a delicious recipe for you today. They're healthy egg muffin cups, so very easy, and we've kind of been going with themes of healthy, fun, easy recipes, and this fits right in with that.
So even if you're in a hurry, you can make these ahead of time.
Oh, yes.
And definitely nutritious. They're going to have a lot of protein. Get your vegetables in the morning, so you're going to get a lot of vitamins and minerals, and good way to start your day.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, this is live. We want to hear from you. If you have any questions or comments, we want to hear from you. Now's your time to pick the brain of Olivia, a registered dietitian here at Parkview. Again, we want to hear from you, and let's get started. Now, I know this recipe starts with vegetables.
Yes.
And again, that's important any meal of the day. Let me ask a quick question first. People say breakfast is the most important meal of the day. Is that true?
Yeah. So while you've been asleep for however long, 6 to 8 hours, your body has been not getting any calories, any protein, any nutrients.
Mm-hmm.
So you are devoid of those things, and you need not the second you get up, but within an hour of getting up, it's a good idea to get some protein, get a little bit of carbohydrates to kickstart your metabolism and get it going for the day so that you're not tired when you go to work or when you go to school, stuff like that.
Okay, and this recipe fits right into that. We're getting a little bit of everything there.
Yeah.
The vegetables that we're starting off with, we're sauteing a cup of peppers, a cup of red peppers, and a cup of onions. And after they've been sauteing a little bit, we add some mushrooms, because those don't take as long to saute.
Yeah.
And then add a little bit more greens, some spinach. You can loosely chop that as well.
Get a good variety of colors. So the more colorful the vegetables are, the more vitamins and minerals you're gonna get from them. So we have a lot of greens and reds, as well as getting some mushrooms and onions. So kind of good variety of flavors as well.
Oh yeah, and it smells fantastic. And we're going to make this smell actually a little bit better. It also calls for a teaspoon of garlic, minced garlic, and you add that in kind of at the very end. That cooks up a little bit quicker.
Shouldn't take too long.
No. And it not only smells great, that garlic has benefits as well, right?
Yep. Definitely helps with metabolism, and it's just good. It'll be add good flavor to your eggs and the rest of your base.
Okay. Well, speaking of eggs, as these kind of saute a little bit more and cook down a little bit more, how many eggs go into this recipe?
So we're going to do 4 egg whites and then 4 whole eggs.
Okay.
So then by doing the egg whites part, you know, half egg white, you're going to be taking some of the fat and calories out.
Okay.
And still keeping a lot of protein, but not adding quite as many calories to your breakfast.
Okay.
So if you're health conscious or weight conscious, this is definitely a good option.
Okay. Now, if there's some myths out there about eggs and cholesterol, what's the story behind that?
So the cholesterol you're going to find in the egg yolk. Mm-hmm. So if your cholesterol is high, it would probably be good to do more egg whites because all of the fat and the cholesterol is found in the egg yolk. That's not to say that if your cholesterol is okay, you know, doing the half and half is probably fine.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're already, you know, taking medication to lower your cholesterol and stuff, it'd probably be good to not overdo it with the egg yolk.
Okay. All right. This recipe calls for a little salt and pepper, so I'm just adding a little seasoning to it. I don't even think it will need that, but just a little salt and pepper. This is looking really good. Of course, smelling good as well.
Yes.
And then we'll just end up combining this. Now, again, in the beginning, you said that this can be made ahead of time and then eaten throughout the week?
Yes.
How would you store that?
Depends on how you want to do it. I think probably the best way would be to make this like if you want to make it on Sunday when you have a day off or something, and then keep it in the refrigerator in a sealed container or in baggies if you want to. Like, it would be something that you could take to work and throw in the microwave. Depending on how much time you've got in the morning.
Okay.
So.
Could you freeze it as well?
The eggs might not, the texture wise, it wouldn't do anything as far as be bad or nutritionally, there's not going to be issues with it, but it, the texture might be a little bit different if you freeze it.
Okay. So you pull it out of the freezer or the refrigerator, just throw it in the microwave, mm-hmm. and then you already have your breakfast. So
yeah.
Just a little bit of prep. I mean, this is taking not even 15 minutes to do. And I think this looks fantastic. Again, it's colorful.
Yeah.
The more color, the better, correct?
Yes.
All right.
For sure.
So we will just add this in here.
Stir it up.
Stir it up. Good. And we've actually laid out some other options. You know, if you wanted to add something to the vegetables, you can add some cubed ham, some low-fat cheddar cheese, correct?
Yes. Just so we're not adding tons of calories and fat.
Right, right. And then I just kind of came up with this idea this morning, but maybe even adding a little taco seasoning and adding some salsa on top of it.
I love salsa with eggs. That's always a good option.
I do too, and even a little hot sauce. I think some people would probably love doing that. All right, here comes the fun part. We're just going to add this in to our muffin tray. Okay. And let me move some of that. And this should make 12 muffins.
It's nice just to use a measuring cup. We have a third of a cup here, mm-hmm. Just so that you're not like trying to pour this huge bowl into your muffin tin.
Okay, and we're looking at about 50 calories per muffin.
Yes, yeah.
Our egg muffins. All right, I'm gonna go grab the ones that we've already cooked. I'm gonna grab them out of the oven right now so we can see. These look absolutely delicious. How long were these in the oven?
15 to 20 minutes, kind of depending on your oven. You kind of want to see golden brown slightly around the edges just so that you know it's done. And if you shake it, it shouldn't be too runny in the middle.
Okay, all right. And we'll just plate these up here. They're a little warm because they're literally
fresh out
of the oven. But these cooked up. Perfect. So again, you eat a couple, that's 100 calories.
Mm-hmm.
Once these cool down, you put them in an airtight container. They'll last up to 4 days in the refrigerator. And then you have breakfast on the week or breakfast on the go. Very quick. That's fantastic. All right, I'm going to cut into this so we can kind of see. Yeah, that looks so good. And again, that was quick. It was easy. I even think kids would love it.
Yeah.
It might be a good way to sneak some vegetables in there.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, good. Olivia, thank you so much for joining us today.
No problem.
And showing us this food demonstration. We'll be back next Friday for our final Facebook Live. Thank you, everyone, for joining us, and we'll see you next week.